Well, first of all, I want to thank you very much for the movie and for the presentation and the recognition of the need and the power of nonviolence. And of course, it's a tactic, and of course, it's something which is generated from within. But what Dr. King focused upon was the need to love the enemy, to see the enemy as a person who is engaged and caught up and tortured, much in the way those who are oppressed feel it. It may not have worked in Auschwitz, but it sure as hell would have worked on the streets of Berlin in the early 1930s to have prevented an Auschwitz. I think Ramallah, Bethlehem, Israel is not like Auschwitz. It's more like the streets of Berlin, I think, in the 1930s. Where there are some rational people, people who see themselves and in their own religious affirmations proclaim themselves to be persons with compassion and understanding. And yet they engage in this force of violence and destruction largely out of a defensiveness, feeling it is necessary. And I think the beauty of this film is to show us that it's not necessary. There are alternatives. That we need not live in fear. The other flip side of fear is not a fearlessness, but rather it is a capacity to see the other, to see the enemy as a person, and to appeal to him. It took 100 years after the abolishment of legalized slavery to end the slavery that existed in our system, and we're still fighting it out. We still have gross and vast inequities in the allocation of resources and opportunities. But we're well on the road to it out of our understanding that the other is a human. And we have to try to find within ourselves the capacity to love that other. That violence only begets more violence. We came away from World War II a more violent nation. And we inflict our violence upon that part of the world that we thought we were once saving it. But nonviolence induces that capacity to love. That's an important element. It's probably the most radical force in the world. And thank you very much.